Moritz, the world's most glamorous alpine retreat, famous for its sun, snow and champers. A resort that was forever immortalised by the ultimate playboy, James Bond, who was chased down the slopes of St Moritz numerous times. And when the film stars were in need of a break from skiing, this is where they would come.
Hi, Christina. Good to see you. Welcome back.
La Marmite, perhaps the only restaurant in the world serving truffles and caviar at 8,000 feet.
Those are for sure some of our signature dishes we are known for. And people from all over the world come here to taste them or to savor them in it. Let's try to cover it up.
Bretto's famous truffle pizza costs $120. But his guests are always ready to spend big.
Here's our pizza, and here is the Robespierre with truffles. Never forget, you need always somebody who buys it, who has the potential to afford it, who can yes. afford it. This is maybe, $500?
$500, okay. Well, I'll take that and put it in my pocket.
I'll smell it when you walk out.
According to the St Moritzers, winter tourism was started here at the Combe Hotel 150 years ago, where guests were treated to every luxury.
Voilà, this is the dining room. In here, 1878, on a Christmas Eve, the first electric light bulb burned in Switzerland.
Ceremonies no more than herald the sporting rivalry between nations.
The Olympic tradition runs deep in St Moritz. The Winter Games were hosted twice here in 1928 and 1948. Winter Olympic Games at St Moritz. One man who's trying to preserve that legacy is Rolf Sachs.
You. Welcome to the Olympic Stadium.
Thank you.
Who not only bought the site, but transformed it into his home.
So this is your back garden.
This is my back garden.
And here is where the crowds would sit on the banks just opposite to watch the games.
Exactly. You had the opening ceremony here. You had the closing ceremony, the ice hockey games and the speed skating event.
Behind us, the Olympic flag is still flying on the
bell
tower. It is
still flying. I always have it flying when I'm in the house.
Yes.
Millionaires like Rolf are transforming the landscape of St Moritz, and they're always welcome here. But some need to keep their excesses in check.
We once had a guest who came here who owned a jumbo jet, a Boeing 747, and he asked for an extension of the runway here at the nearby airport, which had in consequence that we would have to destroy a whole village for his runway. So people, of course, did not even discuss about it. He came with a smaller plane then.
Well, I'm glad to hear it.
Christina McFarlane, CNN, St Moritz.